Haere mai rā.
Please be seated. Ana mana, ana reo, ana hui whā. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Council members, members of the university, special guests, graduands, families and friends. I extend a warm welcome to this, the 8th autumn graduation ceremony for 2012. Of the University of Auckland. This week, the university is bestowing a total of 7,048 qualifications on some 6,862 students. At this ceremony, degrees will be conferred and diplomas awarded in the Faculty of Education, a total of 569 in person, plus a further 123 in absentia. As Chancellor, I am privileged to preside at graduation once more. The twice-yearly cycle of graduation ceremonies makes them no less significant for the university and me personally than for those of you being capped here today, many for the first and only time. Graduation is always a festive event, rich in history, pomp and colour, but with some endearing contemporary touches. And here in Auckland, our enviable mix of cultures and ethnicities is evident in the variety of dress and adornments worn by some graduands. Today is one of celebration, hard-earned and well-deserved by you, the graduands and diplomates on your academic feats, and by your family and friends who have encouraged and supported you in good times and in bad, and who are here to rejoice in your success. The university, represented by the council and academic staff members seated behind me, and those many professional staff who direct proceedings with unerring precision, takes equal satisfaction in your hugely significant day. The University of Auckland is deservedly ranked as one of the best universities in the world. The qualifications bestowed on you today will always serve you well, in this country and abroad, whether in qualifying you for a fulfilling career or in leading to further challenging study or simply for your own personal and intellectual enrichment. In today's world of constant and often bewildering change, you can never afford to stop learning and honing your skills and capabilities. so do keep in mind our ever-expanding range of postgraduate opportunities. The critically important role of major research-led universities, such as the University of Auckland, in modern life is not always understood. Our cutting-edge research is vital for long-term sustainable economic growth and social development, never more so than in these globally uncertain economic times. Universities such as ours equip graduates like you not simply for the jobs of today, but for careers not yet imagined. The University of Auckland's aspirations for the period ahead and our responses to an increasingly constrained funding environment are comprehensive and demanding. They are taking shape in our draft strategic plan for 2013 to 2020. I encourage you to peruse this wide-ranging document on our website and let us have your feedback. I urge you, as eminent alumni of New Zealand's leading university, always to remember your alma mater. We depend increasingly on our graduates for support, moral and political, as well as financial. This at a time when our country's universities receive the lowest income per student in the developed world. Your advocacy and influence are vital in encouraging government and the community at large to fund universities so they can generate the knowledge needed to drive a productive and competitive economy and to create full and satisfying lives for all New Zealanders. But that's enough for me on the challenges currently facing universities. For today is unquestionably your day. I warmly congratulate each and every one of you and trust that you will long cherish memories of your graduation in May 2012. Our speaker at this morning's ceremony is Michael Stanley, who chairs the Vodafone New Zealand Foundation. The mission of this foundation is to improve the health and well-being of young New Zealanders through charitable partnerships, programs, networking and relationship building. Mr. Stanley grew up in Brisbane and qualified in social work at the University of Queensland. He worked for 12 years as a social worker in Australia, the UK, and this country, specialising mainly in child protection and also worked with isolated Aboriginal communities. He then moved into HR, working for Telstra in Australia, running his own consultancy, and working for AMP. Before joining Vodafone Australia. In 2008, he came to Vodafone New Zealand to take on the challenge of being Director of HR. Mr. Stanley is passionate about the role and value of the Vodafone New Zealand Foundation. He sees it as offering a chance to Vodafone's 1,500 staff to make a positive difference in their local communities. Mr. Stanley.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of the Council, members of the University, guardians, family and friends, and graduates. Kia ora, welcome and g'day. 569 people graduating today. Congratulations. What a magnificent achievement. I hope today that you take the opportunity to celebrate. You deserve it. I also hope that today you take the opportunity to find just a little space of time to stop and to reflect, to think over what has driven your success, what has led to your achievement, which is being beautifully acknowledged this morning. I hope also you had the opportunity to reflect with gratitude on all those people who've supported you to arrive here today. Family, friends, loved ones, the staff of the university who have been committed to your success and to your achievement. And I also wish that for today, you also find some space to look ahead, to consider the future, to dream of what's possible, and to reflect on your ambitions. Michelangelo, the very great 16th century Italian master, scientist, and artist, said to us, "The greater danger for most of us lies not in setting our aim too high and falling short, but in setting our aim too low and achieving the mark." I encourage you to dream big, to dream wide, to dream with ambition. In preparing for today, I was reflecting back to 1979 when I graduated with a Bachelor of Social Work from the University of Queensland. At that time, I had no idea of the opportunities that that qualification bestowed upon me. I had no sense that that degree would enable me, provide me with a ticket to live and work across Australia, here across New Zealand, in the United Kingdom, in Hong Kong, and then in addition to that, to consultant work with businesses throughout Europe and throughout Asia Pacific. Dream big, I encourage you. I was recently at a dinner with John Key, and John Key gave an address, and in that address he told the story of his mother. And John Key's mother was born in Vienna, in Austria, and she was born just prior to the Nazi Germany invasion of Austria, and John Key's mother was Jewish. One of her aunts managed to get out of Austria after the German invasion and moved to the UK. And at that time, it was possible if you were married to a British citizen to bring two relatives from abroad. So his mother's aunt paid a British soldier to marry her, and literally within days, she had managed to take John Key's mother and a younger brother out of Vienna to the UK. During the war that unfolded, Mrs. Key's entire family perished. She'd come from quite a wealthy background. All of the family assets, wealth, disappeared. So she found herself with two relatives in a foreign land, and she had to completely reinvent her life and re-establish herself. She had a second major transformation of her life many years later, having married and immigrated to New Zealand, where she and her husband had established a very successful, prosperous business here in Auckland, where they ran a series of restaurants. But Mr. Key suffered a fatal heart attack at a very early age, leaving his wife with three young children. And on the death of her husband, Mrs. Key was informed that actually the business that she believed to be prosperous was in ruins. The business needed to be declared bankrupt, all the assets sold, and Mrs. Key took her three young children, moved to Christchurch, where John Key famously grew up in state housing, went to a decile one school, and really struggled to succeed, and his mother, throughout his childhood, had two, three jobs. What John Key said, that the one legacy of his mother, what she was determined to do for him, was to provide him with the best possible education. And why? Because she believed that in life you can lose everything. Everything can be taken from you, but no one can take from you your education, your knowledge, your growth. So today we acknowledge your education, your achievement. May it be the start or the continuation of a life rich with learning, with challenge, with growth, with opportunity. And just to finish, I would like to share with you a blessing. It is an ancient blessing, it's 40,000 years old, and it comes from the peoples of the Burrumburrum in northeast Australia, my homeland. And it is a blessing of fire, and it is offered to you. May the fire be in your thoughts, making them true, good, and just. May it protect you from the evil one. May the fire be in your eyes. May it open your eyes to share what is good in life. We ask that the fire protect you from what is not rightfully yours. May the fire be in your lips so that you may speak in kindness, that you may serve and encourage others. May it protect you from speaking evil. May the fire be in your ears. We pray that we may hear with deep, deep listening so that you can hear the flow of the water and of all creation and the dreaming. May you be protected from gossip and from things that harm and break down your family. May the fire be in your arms and hands so that you may be of service and build up love. May the fire protect you from all violence. May the fire be in your whole being, in your legs and in your feet, enabling you to walk the earth with reverence and with care, so that you may walk in the ways of goodness and truth and be protected from walking away from what is truth. This morning, I congratulate you sincerely, and on your journey ahead, I wish you the very, very best. Thank you.
On behalf of the graduates, Mr. Stanley, can I thank you for some very interesting, entertaining and insightful remarks. And could I ask the graduates to show their appreciation again to Mr. Stanley? This is a meeting of council and convocation of the university for a ceremony of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. At this ceremony, the Pro-Chancellor, Dr. Ian Parton, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
Thank you, Chancellor. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within their faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Education, Associate Professor Aitken, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Education. Graduate Diploma in Education. Mari Jane Arpenning. Rebecca Ann Beattie. Raywin Margaret Cameron. Signa Grace Cunningham. Glenys Joan Drew. Jacinta Hall. Jose Carlos Hugo. Martin David Kawana. Alfred Chi-Wai Ko. Joanne Carol Martin. Hester Katharina Mintz. Heather Mitchell. Karen Margaret Mora. James Hanshra Ram. Jeanette Rizzetto. Eddie Skipper. Jeanette Beard Douglas III. Karolini Sarataisa Tutavaha. Graduate Diploma in Special Education, Paula Jury Baker. Ronalda Leslie Chitty. Rebecca Claire Creswick. Ediko Edith Dittrich. Richard Dittrich. Sharon Dale Fox. Sarah Rose Ta'otaha Grace Wada. Claire Rosamond Helen Harper Lee. Diana Beverly Harrison. Heidi Maria James. Monica Ma'u. Joanna Barbara Moana. Judith Raymond O'Connell. Burnette Niall Peters. Marlene Patricia Revel. Jan Mary Elizabeth Turnbull. Graduate Diploma in Teaching Secondary, Logan Bruce Adams. Josefina Lomialangi Leonora Sosefina Arsan. Destiny Anderson. Joshua William Andrews. Natasha Louise Bagley. Emily Julia Bajan. Claire Jane Bailey. Rachel Elizabeth Bate. Anna Jane Lilius Beasley. Joel Michael Burnett. Stephen Leonard Black. Sally Jane Bowden. Katie Sue Baskell. Stacey Jane Brown. Tamara Jane Brown. Deborah Joy Buckland. Matthew Peter Buckley. Christopher Lawrence Bushell. Christopher William Calder. Andrew Greg Cowan. Genevieve Rose Craig. Duncan David Darich. Leah Rosemary Dempster. Emily Irene Donovan. Benedict Cosmos D'Souza. Kylie Ann Dunlop. Catalina Espinosa. Narissa Offa Fale. Jonathan Piers Richard Fall. Pearl Rosemary Fenty. Hazel Rosalind Fong. Tapaeru Ariki Cecily French. Oliver William Joseph Gilmore. Scott Anthony Greenwood. Thomas John Hahn. Janice Allegra Hayes. Harriet Adelaide Hellyer. David Thacker Holmes. Catherine Louise Hunter. Grace Ikinasio. Marie Helene Huguet Suzanne Imbio. Selva Jimenez Calvo. Shireen Kadam. Alana Victoria Kempthorne. Chloe Ann King. Natasha Louise King. Jason Stewart Knowles. Anshu Avantika Kumar. Ati Vikashni Kumar. Anne-Marie Lalakai. Deborah Jane Leilua. Sean Alexander Wiley Liggins. Michelle Marie Lomberg. Margarita Josephine Fahavai-Loto. Dawn Marie Lauman. Patricia Mahaleone Patumaka Makata. Scott David Mansell. Neomai Sarah Mark. Melissa Rachel Martin. Ruby Caledonia Masson. Jalen Ofa Lotoki Vavau Mataele. Norika Matsuda Tubman. Shona Mata. Jessica Rose Matthews. Stephen Trevor McCracken. Stacey Ann Mackay. Claire Margaret McMillan. Sarah Jane McNeil. Samoa Maya. Lucy Helen Miles. Shirley Leilani Misile. Tanya Rochelle Mitchell. Zoreen Nafisa Muhammad. Robin Idris Morgan Jones. Strujith Heman Muthiaya. Masha Joella Nair. David Desmond O'Halloran. Rebecca Jane, Leanne O'Leary. Daksha Ben Patel. Manoj Jitendra Patel. Rasmita Patel. Thomas Edward Pearson. Jesse Renee Peniamena. Karen Elizabeth Perido Alcorn. Emma Therese Phillips. Lee Jun Chu. Ashish Prafo Rambai. Marissa Vanita Ramlu. Michael John Randall. Aidan Lindsay Richards. Jared Wayne Riseborough. Andrew Joseph Rogers. Mila Romich. Kimberly Erin Schumacher. Tauira Nadine Scott Patterson. Rebecca Jill Simon Scholes. Christopher Allen Smith. Emily Gillian Megan Stewart. Margarita Frederick Strick. Siosiana Tokolo. Sarah Christine Teer. Tahuariki Tofitu Thompson. Bessie Paulina Tuiali. Alexandra May Vincent. Brad Stewart Whalen. Gemma Kate Annie Ward. Sarah Jean Ward. Kerry Ann Watts. Vera Linda Williams. Lorraine Wu. Bingmei Zhang. Graduate Diploma in Teaching English in Schools to Speakers of Other Languages. Catherine Ann Bartlett. Shibani Shrikant Pave. Desiree Joy Camphor. Niall Dale Duffy. Victoria Mary Goodyear. Kereana Tawairata McClatchy. Fiona Elizabeth Mary. Natalie Justine Mitchell. Dayananthan Naidu. Pushpa Wati Ram. Ruth Louise Round. Kathleen Mary Scott. Christine Margaret Francis Southey Sami. Louisa Helena Tuitupo. Bronwyn Ann Wilkinson. To the degree of Bachelor of Education, Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages. Kathur Abdul Halim. Norshahida Fatiha Abdul Rahman. Sariza Shay Sari. Nofariha Muhammad Sharum. Nadila Rosley. Haniza Shahul Hamad. Wan Nurul Atika Wa Azmi. Nurul Ashikin Yusuf. Muhammad Farid Zakaria. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching, Adrian Sharon Eckerman. Luisa Tupo Aliamotua. Barbara Ann Alexander. Nathaniel Iosefa Alexander Pua. Lily May Andrews. Marilyn Janice Andrews. Vicky Janelle Appleton Tattersall. Gillian Lee Armit. Grayson Charles Aspinall. Nicholas Aaron Bateman. Susan Dawn Bayless. Regan Mark Bell. Simone Lee Belton. Liddy Anne-Laurie Marie Bernard. Stacey Ann Benson. Elsa Siule Birking. Jade Nicole Bloom. Letitia Marie Bone. Tanya Nicole Boniface. Senior Scholar Education, Janelle Amy Booth. Linda K. Braid. Donna Lee Bregman. Shelley Lynn Brocklesby. Claire Pangea Brooke Smith. Maren Grace Brown. Stephanie Marie Bruce. Zara Lee Buckman. Holly Ann Burke. Samantha Susan Byrne. Sheena Marie Campbell. Brigitte Claire Canton Gilmore. Lila Mackenzie Ruaho Rawiri Carmichael. Sridevi Chalagula. Grace Lee May Chan. Yida Grace Chang. Ashwini Prem Chowan. Sophia Yinyu Chen. Senior Scholar, Education, Lauren Brian Clark. Hannah Renee Clark. Rebecca Jane Clarkson. Jordan Danielle Cole. Rochelle Ann Cole. Senior Scholar Education, Elizabeth Ann Coleman. Nicholas William Colling. Philippa Ann Connicky. Vicky Lynette Cooper. Melanie Amy Cronin. Hayley Marie Crowther. Wendong Dai. Tina Marie Dean. Megan Kate Denton. Clifford James DiPiazzi. Chelsea Scarlett Divine Valasame. Emma May Donaldson. Catherine Elizabeth Dwyer. Manager Sujiwani Ediri Wikrama. Deborah Fife Ellery. Ruth Elizabeth Christine Elliott. Amy Catherine Ellis. Jessica Louise Ellis. Rebecca Louise Ellison. Tyson Wade Iduera. May Falanico. Jennifer Ann Farrell. Jillian Barbara Falding. Heidi Christina Fagan. Emmy Pepulei. Hannah Pepulei. Heather Jean Ferguson. Natalie Rosaline Ferrand. Sarah Jane Fathol. Jamie Alice Fletcher. Hayley Louise Flint. Patisi Fonua. Craig Allen Ashton Forster. Christina Joanne Fortes. Ibis Flinda Freddy. Janine Gay Fryer. Zoe Barbara Fryer. Jill Elizabeth Garten. Julia Mary Gates. Rachel Louise Gavin. Kaylee Ann Giel. Lisa Marie Gooder. Jane Pamela Gordon. Leanne Julie Gordon. Gillian Merle Granger. Warren Neil Green. Emily Joan Grice. Benjamin Ryan Griffiths. Bronwyn Jan Groombridge. Lisa Marie Guest. Sheena Marie Gonong Guntang. Joanne Frieda Hadfield. Miriam Joy Hadfield. Katrina Ann Halstone. Catherine Selena Ann Halcrow. Senior Scholar Education, Amanda Francis Hall. Louisa Hall. Tanithi Marie Hall. Lindsay Ann Hampton. Jessica Marie Hancock. Abby Petter Harris. Kylie Jane Harris. Lyon Caroline Harris. Barbara Ann Harrison. Kelly Ann Hedgman. Rebecca Jane Hellowell. Yvonne Eileen Huvel. Ashley Storm Hewitt. Charlotte Marie Hurihia Hohepa. Laura Ann Holder. Tanikia Valerie Neely Holtham. Jane Hayward Horner. Linda Jane Hovard. Neil Edward Howe. Eileen Ann Hoyle. Fan Hua. Hannah Elizabeth Maria Hubers. Jai Yun Hu. Lauren Louise Hukui. Tanya Leanne Ireland. Persia Anne Iwan. Sarah Elizabeth Jacobs. Stephanie Nicola James. Claire Marie Jamison. Sherilyn Ann Jarvis. Lungi Jenkins. Amy Lee Johnson. Bonnie Monica Jones. Lucia Ella Jowsey. Hope Renee Kahui Ha'apai. Keta Rima Kaiwai Herbert. K.D. Thalini Plabiba Karuna Ratne. Laura Nicola Keenan. Ashley Jean Keogh. Sarah Jane Gikson-Core. Taijung Kim. Laura Noelle Kingston. Deborah Kitchell. Alicia Claire Corpor. Santaya Devi Kumar. Laina Latif. Fineeva e Finoapai Lawaki. Mala Mala Via. Deborah Sally Lawson. Elise Marion Lawson. Cara Melanie Leach. Prithvi Viba Lathart. Le Uli Alapu Malu Lea Atoa Atoa. Tessa Louise Leona. Jilin Lee. Hafsa Leocart. Carl James Lidstone. Kelly Ann Elizabeth Linehan. Natasha Emma Jade Lines. Cherie Diana Lister. Seska Meleseke Lua Faleola. Sarah Karina Lusich. Kara and Luke. Deborah Grace Lynch. Rebecca Ann Lyons. Senior Scholar Education, Sarah Teresa Mary Lyons. Carla Marie Mackle. Jyotishna Angeline Maharaj. Willis Pataoro Maihi. Leonard Marcus Mayle. Roimata Kamel Manaya. Charlotte Elizabeth Munger. Pamela Sue Manning. Emmeline Ululoloa Manoa. Kirsten Amy Marsh. Philippa Mary Martin. Jade Alana Macefield. Heather Naomi Matthews. Ashley Coral Main. Amanda Raywin McConnell. Bonita Waimaria Mariana McFarland. Lisa Patricia McFarland. Deirdre Louise McGibbon. Theodore McClay. Carol Josephine Mendonza. Kelly Marie Merson. Stefan Wayne Minton. Jose Mary Misson. Joanne Tracy Mitchell. Alisa Kimberly Moldy. Anna Lee Muir. Kirsten Stacey Mulcahy. Natalie Anna Muller. Jonavi Chan Munoz. Senior Scholar Education, Jodie Ann Christine Munro. Laura Joy Murphy. Shana Lee Mutton.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Soo-yong Kim on flute, accompanied by Rosemary Barnes on piano, will now perform Rondo in D major for flute by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. inclined to think that of all the great composers, Mozart's often the easiest to listen to, but it's particularly easy when you have such a beautiful instrument as the flute, and when it's particularly when it's played as beautifully as it just was by Soo-young. Can I ask you to show your appreciation to Soo-young and Rosemary again? Thank you. Each year we have some memorable performances by students from our School of Music, such as the one you've just heard. All graduands and their families who would like to hear further performances of this calibre are invited to the graduation concert at 7:30 p.m. this Saturday in the Town Hall. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Roger France, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Education have satisfied the requirements of this university.
To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching, Hayley Chloe Naismith. Saru Shannon Nelson. Rachel On Kien. Senior Scholar Education, Gayla Margaret Nixon. Connie Francis Noble. Timothy James Noyce. Caitlin Helen O'Connor. Gemma Elizabeth Olson. Senior Scholar Education, Joanne Orchard. Courtney Elizabeth Orr. Timothy John Osborne. Amelia Danica Ozich. Irum Fatima Panju. Alex Marion Patterson. Katie Elizabeth Pierce. Karen Ann Montano Peredo. Marianne Colleen Pettikin. Lyle Cassidy Pillay. Edward Joel Russell Pennell. Bridget Jane Poor. Michelle Marairua Pora. Caitlin Prasad. Diane Mary Pretty. Avay Deborah Bolotu. Malia Falakika Pulunu. Chand Mohini Rai. Stacey Helen Ralston. Rachel Patricia Rowe. Benjamin Joseph Rawson. Morgan Marie Reyes. April Ann Reed. Kathleen Patricia Dawn Reed Watson. Samantha Lee Robinson. Simon Matthew Robinson. Rahul Disma Rodericks. Kate Louise Rogers. Helen Rollo. Michelle Carla Rott. Haley Ann Russell. Lucy Alexa Reiter Gardner. Lalita Cameron Saisu. Siksa Satishwar. Amber Claire Shelford-Berger. Maria Teresa Swass. Tracy Jiajin Seto. Catherine Victoria Rose Sharp. Robert James Shelley. Catherine Grace Simpson. Christina Gioti Singh. Jasdeep Kaur Singh. Ushunthi Rundika Siriwadna. Elizabeth Sivakuma. Renona Saipeti Sivanila Preston. Michael Gavin Smart. Laura Brittany Smith. Lipena Smith. Sarah Annette Smith Pilling. Sarah Louise Somerville. Harshita Sood. Jodie Evelyn Southern. Alana Maria Steens. Annie Martha Stewart. Perry Jane Swan. Regan James Tahia. Regan James Tahia. Tora Talavini Tapuai. Ellen Rosalie Tarling. Norvema Tamala. Pei Ling Tan. Nikita Victoria Tapora. Tavoy Alice Tofalele. Etelita Suzanne Tavalu. Dana Irie Talforth. Nicole Kathleen Taylor. Elizabeth Mary Thomas. Stacey Carol Marie Thomas. Kelly Gwendolyn Thompson. Pearl Marie Thorpe. Durga Devi Tulap. Agnes Patricia Topia. Cheryl Tulia Toloniu. Christine Latasha Tupo. Lealofi Tutoi. Tersha Vadivelu. Poisungo Tonia Vaisangoto Norte. Bevan Andrew Verrett. Stacey Kezia Taniko Vickers. Tracy Vani Lingi Viviani. Serena Elise Walker. Rachel Ruth Walsh. Anna Michelle Wansbone. Conway Newton Waylon Wellis. Hannah Lauren White. Hannah Maria Whittington. Angela June Wikitera. Chantel Williams. Stephanie Rose Williamson. Eileen Ann Willis. Angela Michelle Wilson. Tess Lederwine Wiltenberg. Hin Thet Swar Win. Senior Scholar Education, Helen Eve Withy. Lee Lip Wong. Victoria Selena Wood. Jody Beatrice Chi Cheng Yi. Inaya Ida Zanif. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work, Brianna Coughlin. Emma Cohen. Inho Zhong. Deanne Joy Littlejohn. Michael and Isa Pokoro. Susan Mary Therese Riley. postgraduate diploma in counselling. Diana Ninova Papulova. Postgraduate diploma in education teaching, Stephanie Jane Beresford Duncan. Postgraduate diploma in educational leadership with distinction, Elise Carolyn Broadworth. Glenys Ann Danielle. Naomi Alexandra Rosedale. Catherine Mary Twyford. Postgraduate diploma in educational leadership with merit, Shelley Ann Clark. Jonathan James Daniels. K. Darrell Lowe. Postgraduate diploma in educational leadership, Mary Janine Pottinger. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with First Class Honours. Senior Scholar, Primary Education, Rochelle Alice Dixon. Lauren Elaine Hitchin. Helen Margaret Lares. Elise Holly Fenoroa. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Fleur Bracey. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Olivia Ann Carlton. University Graduate Scholar, Kristen Carla Mette Clark. Ravina, I'm sorry, Kirsten Elise McNabb. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work Honours with First Class Honours, Yong Hee Han. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Fang Fang Chen. Hee Suk Cho. Benjamin James Hugel. Ka Wai Woon. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work Honours with Second Class Honours Second Division, Carol Avoir. Jing Yu Huang. To the degree of Master of Education with First Class Honours, Leonie Fay Bayless. Diane Margaret Collins in Counselling. Daniel James Couch. Janet Ann Francesco in Counselling. Kim Suzanne Ford Henry. Tony Rosalind Ingram. Elizabeth Ann Kane. Brian Joseph Martin. Patricia Agnes McLean in counselling. Athleen Amanda Ramsay. Judith Ann Silvaraj. Anuja Singh. Lisa Marie Watson. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class Honours First Division, Marion Linda Blundell in Counselling. Santino Atam Deng in Counselling. Gillian Maria Halpin. Tanya Marie Luke. Julie Ann Ma. Richard Andrew Nind in counselling. Joy Marie Payton. Heidi Remington in counselling. Janet Elizabeth Rogers. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class Honours Second Division, Sumithra Naidu. Rochelle Leanne Telfer. Ulu Wakavanua. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with First Class Honours, Julia Barbro Laird. Jacqueline Passy. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours First Division, Mark Jonathan Broadworth. Shaquille Mabry in Education. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours Second Division, Elizabeth Maria Jones. James Charles Williams.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Education, Leon Vuca Bernardi, University Doctoral Scholar. Leon showed that a critical and creative implementation of the New Zealand curriculum in schools will enable teachers to take greater ethical control of their work. Elizabeth Ann Probert. Elizabeth investigated teachers' understandings and practice regarding information literacy skills which are needed particularly for research or inquiry learning, and also the effectiveness of an in-school intervention. Findings revealed the need for information literacy skills to be taught explicitly, and that providing effective professional development for this is a complex process. Elizabeth. Cherie Colleen Taylor-Patel. Cherie's research examined the extent to which student-led conferences are effective as a reporting method, how they change teachers' practice, and their impact on the development of student competencies in reporting. Yanni Adriana Gerarda Maria van Hees, University Doctoral Scholar. Yanni investigated the oral expression in English of 5 and 6-year-olds in low socioeconomic schools, their overall competencies, and their quality and quantity of oral expression during class lessons. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Linda Margaret Bendixson in Education. Linda investigated the links between student achievement on the National Secondary School Qualification NSEA and the effectiveness of their school principals. She is now using her research to inform the induction and continuing development of school principals in New Zealand and Australia. Sally Elizabeth Birdsall in Education. Sally investigated teachers' understandings of sustainability and the ways these can be developed. The research has highlighted that changes in behaviour and values of teachers are the linchpin of any significant change in classroom pedagogy for sustainability. Kathleen Ann Niederer in Education. Kate examined the changes to gifted students' self-concepts on moving to a part-time gifted program and the factors that appeared to moderate these changes. Sally Eveline Scott in Education. Sally investigated the particular discursive, political, and practical mechanisms in education and how she came to think of herself as a teacher called a resource teacher learning and behaviour in New Zealand. Owe Teava in Education, University Graduate Scholar. In an action research study, OA investigated how Cook Islands' core values were implemented into teaching culturally responsive pedagogy and how this played an important part in students' learning and relationships with teachers. Melinda Jean Weber in Education. Melinda investigated racial ethnic identities in early adolescence attending large urban multi-ethnic high schools with a view to developing an increased understanding of the role of racial ethnic identities in relation to learning in New Zealand. In absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma.
The university places great importance on teaching, and it recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in particular aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for excellence and sustained excellence in teaching has been made to Dr. Pamela Millwood in the School of Teaching, Learning and Development within the Faculty of Education. I now call upon a student of that faculty, Justine Mary Delport, to read the citation for Dr. Pamela Millwood.
It is both an honour and privilege to stand before you today to publicly acknowledge Dr. Pamela Millwood for the Sustained Excellence in Teaching Award and to highlight the exceptional personal attributes, the pedagogical skills, and the professional qualities that distinguish her. In my eyes, Dr. Pam's greatest asset is her inherent belief that all students are capable of success and deserve the opportunity and support to achieve this. To this end, she strives to create a learning environment that fosters and nurtures the self-belief and self-efficacy of her students so that they feel empowered to achieve success in their academic pursuits. Dr. Pam's approachable style, her empathetic nature, professional manner, and effective feedback support a collaborative and inclusive learning community where excellence and diversity in its myriad of forms is valued and considered integral to the teaching-learning process. She is able to make learning relevant, authentic, and engaging to her students. She does this by taking learning theories and concepts and connecting these to learners' prior knowledge and experiences by using real case studies, her academic knowledge, and personal experiences. The students in her class truly value her innovative and unique teaching style, and this has engendered a reflective learning approach whereby they are encouraged to discover their own personal perspectives, values, and ideas in the educational milieu and to challenge existing paradigms that do not align to their personal teaching philosophies. On a personal note, Dr. Pam has inspired me to reach heights that I had not aspired to or even dreamed of before entering tertiary education. Through her gentle but firm leadership and her calm, reassuring disposition, I know that I am better for having her as an active and able mentor in my learning journey. Dr. Pamela is, in my opinion, most worthy of this award, as she truly embodies all the values and ideals for which this award stands.
On behalf of the university, can I now invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And this would be the ideal opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of Council and convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori and then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programs.